Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to show you how to generate or to simulate a general continuous random variable from its distribution function. So, like in the previous video, I'm going to start with a little bit of math at the board to show you some tricks, and then we can apply that to really computer program, and then at the end of this video I'm going to show you a C program where we can indeed generate a continuous random variable. And because the only one that we are going to use after to simulate stochastic processes is the exponential random variable, that's the one we need to quantify the waiting time between jumps of a continuous Markov chain. That's this one that I'm going to choose to illustrate what I'm going to talk about. So, I remind you that a continuous random variable is characterized, or any random variable by the way, but in particular, like continuous random variable are characterized by their distribution function. And so I remind you that if you have a continuous random variable X, the distribution function is this function capital F of little x that is equal to the probability that capital X is less than little x. Okay, and so if you draw a picture of this function, like the graph of this function, so we know that this is a non-decreasing function. The limit at minus infinity is zero, the limit at plus infinity is one. That follows directly from the definition of this, like, as a probability. And just in the picture, I'm just going to assume that x is positive. And so eventually, the graph of this function looks like that. That's a function that is equal to zero at zero, that's equal to zero on the negative number. And then here you have the value one, and that's going to be the limit of your function. And so your function here, f of x, looks like that. Okay, so that's again non-decreasing, starting at zero, at point zero, limit at plus infinity should be equal to one. Okay, so that's our that's how we can characterize the function. So that's function f here. And so now the question is, how can we generate this object starting from the uniform random variable, uniform in the interval 0, 1. So why should we start with uniform? Well, that's because this is the thing that I explained how to generate in my previous video. So I'm starting from what we know already. So what we know from the previous video is how to generate a uniform random variable in the interval 0, 1. That's not completely random, that's not exactly continuous, but we saw how to generate something that is a very good approximation of this uniform random variable. So the trick is simple, that's this. Here you have interval 0, 1, and then after generating this one using a computer, you can just look at the value of u here. So maybe u is going to be here. And then what you are going to do is look at the horizontal line here. You look at this value and then you go down here. And so here you are going to have x. That's how you can generate, okay, mathematically, a continuous random variable from the uniform random variable in the interval 0, 1. So this picture means that here you have f of x equals u, okay? F of x equals u, so that means also that f of x equals u for this function f. So now I'm taking really the actual capital X. Capital X is our random variable and capital U is uniform. And this equation is an equation in distribution. And so obviously that's the same as saying that X is equal to F minus one of U. And again, that's an equation in distribution. So this trick shows you how to simulate a continuous random variable if you know, of course, the distribution function from a uniform random variable. What you do is you simulate a uniform random variable between 0 and 1, and then you look at F inverse of U, where F is the distribution function, and then that should give you exactly your random variable X. So now let's see what happens in the case of the exponential random variable. And you remember that the only thing that really matters to us is to generate uniform, and so to generate exponential. And so most of the work is to find the inverse of this function, and that's it. And so let's assume now that X is exponential in the with parameter mu. Okay, so that means that a characterization of the exponential is the fact that f of x is equal to e to the minus no 1 minus e to the minus mu x. Okay? Now, that's also convenient to use another characterization just by looking at the complement of this event. We know also that exponential means that the probability that x is strictly larger than little x is equal to e to the minus mu x. Okay, so now we want to generate this object x here. And so the trick, again, is to use this. And so to inverse the function, what I'm going to do is just say that start from that, we know that let's say I'm going to do a little calculation here. So u equals f of x, that's this, 1 minus e to the minus mu x. So obviously that means that e to the minus mu x is equal to 1 minus u. Okay, then you take the log, that means that minus mu x is equal to log of 1 minus u. And then you divide by negative mu, and then that tells you that little x is equal to log 1 minus u, you need a minus also here, and mu divided by mu. Okay, so this little calculation was just to find the inverse of f in the case of the exponential random variable. And so what this tells you here, what this equation tells you is that x, your exponential random variable, can be generated by choosing a uniform random variable in the interval 0, 1, and then looking at this quantity, negative natural log of 1 minus u, your uniform random variable, divided by mu, is equal in distribution, so that's going to indeed generate an exponential random variable with parameter mu. Now, one more trick I want to show you. So of course that doesn't work for any continuous random variable, but that's just something interesting to observe here. You see that if u is uniform in the interval 0, 1, well, 1 minus u is again uniform in the interval 0, 1. You just look at the symmetry of the thing, so that's exactly the same. So 1 minus u is equal to u. Not obviously, almost surely, but 1 minus u is equal to u in distribution. And so to generate your x here, you don't even need to look at the natural log of 1 minus u, you can just look at the natural log of u. So conclusion of our calculation here is the fact that our exponential random variable x, to simulate it, you can just look at minus the natural log of a uniform random variable in the interval 0, 1, and you divide this by mu. That's going to generate an exponential. And so now I can kind of show you that indeed this works. So I'm just stating this result here, but with no proof. I'm not going to prove it in the general case, but at least we can prove it for the exponential non-variable. So now, to prove that this one is indeed exponential with parameter mu, the only thing I need to do is to prove this. That's a characterization of the exponential non-variable. And so let's look at this. So what is the probability that x is larger than little x? That's the probability that this is larger than little x. So minus log capital U divided by mu. We want this to be larger than little x. Okay, so that means that this thing is the probability that log u is less than minus mu x. Okay, so I multiply by mu on both sides, mu is positive, but then I have this minus that I put on the other side, so I change this inequality. And then I can take the exponential on both sides, and so that's exactly equal to the probability that u is less than e to the minus mu x. And now e to the minus mu x is going to be a number between 0 and 1, and so the probability that u is less than that, that's exactly what we saw in the previous video to generate a Bernoulli random variable. We said that we look at the probability that a uniform is less than p, that's going to be just equal to p. So this one is just equal to, because that's uniform between 0 and 1, this probability is just equal to that number, e to the minus mu x. So it's equal to e to the minus mu x. And so indeed, that's this expression. So what we proved here is that indeed, if u is uniform in the interval 0, 1, then this new quantity here, negative log u divided by mu, is indeed going to be the exponential random variable with parameter mu. So now let's look at a concrete computer program to see how we can indeed generate an exponential random variable. So here is an actual C program that generates the exponential random variable with parameter mu. So I start exactly like before with declaring some libraries. Don't worry about that. That's not about like really simulating the random variables. Then after, we need to define the parameter of this exponential random variable. I'm calling it mu. I fix mu equals to 1, but you can change this value if you want to generate an exponential random variable with another parameter. Then I need to declare, like to introduce two variables we are going to use. They are both floats for real number. The first one, u, is going to play the role of our uniform random variable that we use to generate the exponential, and the other one that I call ex is our exponential random variable itself. I'm calling it ex instead of exp because exp is already used by C for the exponential function. So then I'm going to skip a lot of things after because I already explained that in the previous video. This subroutine that starts with, on the left, float uniform is the subroutine we need to choose a number uniformly at random in the interval 0, 1. I already explained that before. And then moving to the right of the screen, we have our main program. Again, the three lines, I also already explained that in the previous video. That's basically using those three lines that you are going to choose a seed for your pseudo-random generator or your chaotic sequence that will kind of mimic randomness. And this seed is chosen based on the actual time, the time on your computer. So let's skip all this. And what really matters in this program that we explained on the board, that just those two lines where we define u and ex. So u is just going to be uniform between the interval 0, 1. So u is defined from the subroutine on the left that's going to choose a number uniformly at random in the interval 0, 1. And then your exponential random variable ex is equal in distortion, that's exactly what we just explained on the board, to negative natural log of u divided by mu. And so that's this quantity here that I'm defining. And so those two lines are going to indeed generate your exponential on a variable. Then I conclude the problem with a print f so that the result, the outcome of this exponential random variable is indeed displayed on the screen. That's exactly like in the previous video, except that now we deal with a continuous random variable. The set, like the range of your random variable is a set, like is a real, the outcome is a real number. So instead of displaying with this common printf with a percentage I for integer, now we need to use a percentage f for float, meaning that we want to display a real number, and the real number we display is ex, our exponential random variable. So this little program generates an exponential random variable. We are going to use that in all the next videos that deal with continuous time Markov chain. That's what we are going to use, this minus log u divided by mu, to be able to simulate the waiting time between jumps in a continuous time random walk. Now, what you can do, and what I did, you don't see it in the program, but in another program, I use the same thing and add a loop here, and so that I can generate a bunch of exponential random variables, not just one. And running this program, here is the type of outcome you get.